key for Kentucky tomorrow, I think, is to figure out what to do after Frank Kaminsky. I think they could put Willie Cauley-Stein on him, the guy who did not play in last year's game. But Willie probably needs to guard Sam Decker because I'm not sure anybody else can handle him on Kentucky's roster. And if not, who then handles Frank Kaminsky? I think the combination of those two guys and who defends who will be a key tomorrow night.
The keys for Michigan State to beat Duke will be scoring the basketball, running in transition, shooting at a high rate, not turning the ball over. In the first meeting, Michigan State had 13 turnovers, turned into 24 Duke points. Michigan State was 5 of 20 from three-point line. Still shot the ball well, otherwise got good shots. Spartans have to shoot better, really have to outscore Duke. They're not going to hold Duke under 70 in this game, I don't believe.
I think a dark horse player for Kentucky is Dakari Johnson, a guy who actually played a lot of minutes against Wisconsin last year, did a great job against Frank Kaminsky. He's seen his role diminish over the course of this year. Kentucky's just so loaded. He's a projected first-round draft pick, seven-footer, but has not had as much of a role as many people thought he would. He had 10 and 6 the other night in the Sweet 16. If they're looking for a way to sort of neutralize Frank Kaminsky, if Carl Towns can't get it done, he was such an offensive force in the Elite Eight, not so great defensively, look for Dakari Johnson to be that guy.
Under the radar guy for Michigan State, Bryn Forbes. He has been huge in this tournament, just scored 14 points off the bench in the regional final win over Louisville, had the first 5 points of overtime in that game. He had kind of lost his role late in the season, kind of got it back in the Big Ten tournament title game loss to Wisconsin. He's been solid on defense, which has been the big thing with him all year, and now he's hitting his shot, and he gives Michigan State that third real threat from outside to join Travis Trice and Denzel Valentine.
Kentucky wins if it doesn't come out flat, if it comes out defensively prepared, which it did not against Notre Dame, and if Wisconsin doesn't hit 10 of 12 threes in the second half the way it did against Arizona in the Elite Eight. That's a thing that many people have speculated would be the kryptonite for Kentucky, the thing that could beat them if somebody really gets hot from outside the arc. Wisconsin couldn't have been hotter in its last game. That's a tough thing to replicate. If they can, Kentucky's in trouble. If they can't, I think Kentucky wins.
Michigan State wins if it gets to 75 points, is able to get in transition a lot, win the rebounding battle convincingly, and not let Duke hit 10 three-pointers in this game. Michigan State would rather let Jahlil Okafor score a lot of points than let its shooters go off in this game.